Hi, my name is Saachi. I'm a PhD student at CSAIL with Alexandra Madri, and the focus of my work is on building more safe and deployable machine learning systems. And that kind of comes on two fronts. One is understanding why models fail the way they do, and the other is in building tools and methods to build more robust models. So models can behave in ways that are maybe unexpected for humans, and they do that based on whatever data we give it. And so if your data is skewed in some way, you could have the model make perhaps surprising decisions just because that's the feature it's relying on. And so one classic example of this, imagine that you're doing some kind of object recognition and you're trying to detect what animal is in a photo. If I give you a data set which only has cows on grassy farmlands, then it might be the case that you detect a cow just based on the grassy farmland and not actually on the cow. And so then if I give you a cow on a beach during test time, you might not pick up that it's a cow because you're only identifying the grassy farmland. And so that's kind of what I mean when I say spurious correlation or pathology, which is that the model is depending on some brittle feature that is a facet of how we generate the data, but not what it needs to be learning in order to use it safely at the test time deployment. So I think, of course, it would be nice if dataset constructors could keep in mind having balance, because then you wouldn't have these kinds of correlations. Like if you introduce cows in beaches, you wouldn't have this issue. But a lot of times when you're working at scale for these vision datasets, it's hard to even know what axes you should be balancing your data on and which of these axes are going to end up being important. And so one thing that my lab actually focuses on a lot is thinking about these kinds of issues with robustness and model failures, not just from the model architecture side, but more from the dataset side. So can we automatically detect if there's some sort of shift in the distribution or one of these spurious correlations, and can we surface that from the dataset side as an indicator to maybe the model practitioner that maybe you should be having more of this type of image in order to have a more balanced data set. So I think that, and this is becoming more of a focus for academia, but was always a focus for industry, is this idea that models need to perform well, not just on the distribution they were trained on, but on all of the adjacent possible conditions. One example of this that's closer to my heart is self-driving. The types of conditions that you can have are so broad that you really have no hope of covering everything in your training distribution. And for something like self-driving, for example, there's so much data available, but knowing which kind of data you need to gather for your task and what kinds of problems your model might encounter once you deploy it is really important for safely deploying these models. And so that's, for example, one kind of setting that I'm hoping by making robustness more of a priority when we're developing these models, we can create better data sets and then downstream better models for these kinds of high-risk situations.